I define parkour as the art of fluid and efficient movement over obstacles and objects within your path.
It's not a sport.
No.
It's not a martial art. It's not gymnastics.
No.
It's parkour.
It is its own thing.
That's great.
It's an art form. It's a discipline. We don't train for the art to look beautiful. That's not our focus. You're training for the technique to be efficient. So right. The beauty is a byproduct of the efficiency of the movement.
Even when I'm frustrated, I go home and I'm like, I had fun today. You know, I might not have accomplished anything, but I had fun. It was a day well spent.
This comes from obstacle course training?
It does come from French obstacle course training and military, which also came from ancient tribal hunting and gathering.
A lot of the techniques could be useful if you were chasing down an enemy or running from an enemy. It's getting from point A to point B in the cleanest, most efficient way possible?
Yes.
A lot of it is mental. If you come up against a wall that you can't climb, you know, it's too high, you go and find another wall that's a little bit lower, and then you climb that wall. If you can't climb it, you find one that's even lower. You climb the low wall. Once you're good at that, you climb the higher one. Then you get higher and higher and higher. And it's the same thing with obstacles at work and obstacles in life, that you tackle the small things first, and then you work your way up to the big problems.
They say it's one of the rare art forms that you have to train to train for. You need to train your body to be able to train for parkour. I think that the community is really at the heart of parkour. What spreads it, what holds it together, what makes it fun, what keeps it interesting is the community.
Everyone here is really friends, and you know, we can't take things too seriously, you know? Because we are out here, essentially we're jumping around.
These people are more along the lines of people who practice martial arts, more about reaching personal perfection.
It's a hard thing to explain to people who are not training. We just find out different things about ourselves every day, and that makes us, you know, love it even more.
Primarily young guys do this, right?
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
Definitely, but we do have older people who are coming in.
I don't want to leave on a stretcher, but can I learn a couple of fundamental movements?
You can. I mean, the older you are, the slower you should start.
All right, so I'm going to grab my walker, and we'll shuffle over there, and we'll feed the pigeons, and then you'll show me some moves, okay?
Okay.
First thing you're gonna do is squat down. Squat back up.
This is the old man parkour class, I'm getting.
This is for everyone.
Oh.
And you're just gonna keep pushing up.
Exo just said it looks like it hurt. It did.
All right, so we're gonna do a side vault here.
A side vault.
Side vault.
You make it look easy.
I know.
I'll make falling look easy. I'm gonna throw a little something in for you, okay? Come on, show me some love, right?
But I was hoping that you didn't hit your face onto the plank.
I was hoping no one saw that. I came very close to smacking my face.
Besides your, you know, awkward old man style, it was good.
Just show us a little bit more and we'll say goodbye.
Of course, man, right. Of course.